Hey, you are not tuned in to Talk of the Day podcast. This is what Bobby Bishop.
What's up? It is Babs, and today I am hanging out at the Talk of the Day podcast. I want to say you're my homie, but you're not my homie yet. But you do know somebody that I know.
Okay, that might make us homies.
Welcome, Bobby Fish, down to Tampa. How are you?
I'm great.
Now, I was on your Instagram today, and I saw a couple of people leave comments under your video that said, Tampa fuck with Bobby Fish still heavy. Do you come here a lot?
Yeah, I mean, I get booed here a lot. It's probably the most I got booed at in Tampa. Tampa fuck with me, though.
That's what's up. So, Jason Pierre-Paul on the Buccaneers is your homeboy, right?
Yeah, that's my dog.
Have you been to a Bucs game yet?
Nah, I haven't. I can, but I haven't.
Yeah, I DM'd him and I was like, so I'm interviewing your friend Bobby Fishkill and I'm so nervous. Is he a nice guy? He was like, Zoe, stop playing. He's a nice guy.
Yeah. I'm real home down there.
Yeah, for sure. Now, speaking of the Buccaneers real quick, let's do a little icebreaker question because I talked about this on the radio today. So yesterday at the game, Tom Brady got like his 600th touchdown.
Right.
Mike Evans handed a dude from St. Pete the ball.
Right.
The ball, at minimum, was worth $500,000.
Right.
But the dude gave the ball back for $1,000 at the gift shop, which you probably gonna only get him like two items, and he got another ball. What would you do in that situation? Would you ever give the ball back?
If Tom Brady won it, I would give it back. Maybe like a play on the team, I would. But if it's for like the gift shop, nah, like, I had a check.
Right.
At least 200.
So you would give it back for $200,000?
Yeah. I was ready to give that for a band. If I knew it was worth $500, yeah, I probably wouldn't have left the stadium with it, though.
What you mean?
I would have took a Zelle. Cash. Cash, but you got to watch.
Right.
So.
Now, you're from Quincy, Florida, right?
Right.
That's up near the Tallahassee area.
Right.
I've been there before.
Oh, Tallahassee or Quincy?
I've been to both. So I went to a family's homecoming in Tallahassee, and then I went to a juke joint in Quincy.
Ooh, juke joint.
It's probably like only one out there, right?
Right.
And it was a beautiful red ball. She was stripping. You know, I was spending my financial aid money on her at the time.
Okay, okay.
But it was a fight that broke out between a lady that came up there and caught her husband in a club. Do stuff like that happen in Quincy all the time?
Every day.
Is it because everybody know each other?
Exactly.
Damn.
It's small. The population 6,500. Like, probably 6,100. So many people get killed and shit. You can cuss on it?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. But yeah, the population probably like 6,100 right now. It's small.
So is everybody related?
Not everybody related, but like everybody know everybody.
So when you first meet a girl, you was growing up in Quincy, did you have to make sure she wasn't one of your cousins before y'all, you know?
Yeah, like, you still do not. Like, if they say they from Tallahassee, Quincy, you got to do extra research. You some kid in the hole. Yeah.
Have you ever been feeling a girl and then found out she was, like, related somewhere down the line?
Nah, my family's small. Like, I came from somewhere else. Like, I ain't got no family.
One of my cousins trying to hook up with me at a family reunion.
Wow.
It's like her cousins though, so.
How'd that work out?
I'll tell you later.
Alright.
After second cousin, it doesn't count, right?
I don't know.
In the South. I'm just kidding. It's a joke. Flag on the play. Bobby Fitzgale, welcome to Tampa.
Here, Tampa. I love Tampa.
Yes, and you got a show tonight. It's going down at the strip club. I can't wait to come out here and turn up with you.
Definitely turning up.
Now, I was doing some more research on you. You said that you've been to prison like 4 times.
Right.
And when was the last time you've been? When did you get out?
I think it was like 2015. I got like 16. It's been a minute. I've been doing good.
So how long were you locked up for, like, in spurts? Like, years, 2 years?
Yeah, like, the first time, I did, like, 18 months, but I never got out. No, I did 13 months, but I never got out. I caught a consecutive sentence. did 18 months. Then like I got out, I did like 13 months again. And last time I did like 18 months. I just had got out of county. I did 8 months. But fleeing through and say I did. But you know how that goes.
Yeah. Did you have anybody holding you down while you was in there?
Yeah, you know, my girl, young. Now, my team's strong though. My mom, my sister, everybody.
I have a question for you. Is there such thing as jail talk? Like you sell a girl dreams while you locked up, or you always kept it real?
I mean, you saying me personally or people?
Just people in general.
Yeah, of course. People would talk to anybody and they'll talk to the fat fit, chunky, fit with no lid. Anybody. Get out. You might not never see that.
So, I met a dude who said he's going to get out in March. And he doesn't ask me for money or anything.
Yeah.
But should I believe that he's going to be with me when he gets out in March?
I mean, if you got your shit together, if you beneficial, like, he get out and you hold him back, like, he gonna leave or that. He trying to make it up, like, cause when he get out, he ain't really gonna give a damn about you. Unless you hold it down, you feel me?
Right. I mean, I email him every day and stuff, but he doesn't ask me for money, so that's good. But
yeah, but is you gonna let him get the car when he get out every day? Are you gonna cook? Are you gonna trip by him not being there? Like,
where are you gonna go?
Shit, get back to it.
No. It's gonna get back to it. We're gonna get on the path to the gym.
That's what lead it to be jailhouse dreams.
Right.
You turned it to a dream. It could have been happily ever.
I feel like I'm talking to the pimp right now, putting me up on game.
Maybe you will.
Alright, so you got out of jail. Were you making music before you went into jail?
Yeah, I was already hot. I was getting booked for shows, all that.
So when you went in, were you still writing music, like while you were locked up?
Nah, because I don't write, but like, I used to like just freestyle over music on the radio. Like if I hear a song they keep playing, like one time I was like the Lucci and PN brought Every Day with Lit. Mm-hmm. And I think I was saying like, I just hear the lit, something like that, but I was rapping over their words, so like I never just wrote.
Right, so it's always like a punch in thing.
Freestyle.
Now, there is a lot of drill music out nowadays, especially on the Florida scene. Like, what would you tell some of these young dudes who are in that lane right now? Because I'm not saying that people think that prison is a fun place, but I see a lot of guys doing things like, yeah, this motherfucker wanna go to jail. So what would you say to, like, those rappers?
Nah, nobody really wanna go to jail. Like, they just... You just see what they really go through, like, you feel me? Like, them chicks who upload them sticks, they ain't doing that because they want to. Like, they gotta do that. Like, they gotta have sticks.
Right.
And they wanna blow them. So we gonna show you we living what we rapping about, you feel me? So it's like, you know, just do you look, bro. Like, just do it safe, you feel me?
Have you taken any of the younger guys in Florida under your wings?
Shit, they wings just as big as mine. I don't really see me like no bigger than nobody, but a lot of these young cats, like, they really like advanced, like, you feel me? Like, they can teach you something, you feel me? So, like, you can't really take them under your wing. You gotta learn from each other, just balance it out, you feel me?
Now, I like the fact that you're very humble, but you are a big deal. I mean, you signed to Roc Nation. Have you met Jay-Z yet?
No, I met Jay-Z.
How was that interaction?
It was everything you think it was.
I'm gonna be scared.
Nah, you can't be scared.
Now, there was something going around social media that was like $500,000 for taking dinner with Jay-Z. Would you choose it, obviously, the dinner with Jay-Z?
I think Jay-Z would be mad if I take the dinner with Jay-Z.
Yeah, so he would want you to take that $500,000.
Yeah, because I'll take $500,000 and go to the 40-40 one night and eat it and just spend like $60. And send this to Jay. me something in the image. That his brother's sister send it to her. You didn't just send everybody saying, hey, what the hell is it? No.
Now, you got a brother that's currently in the feds right now.
Okay.
So he's one of your biggest supporters. So he listens to your music while he's in there, and does that help him get through the days?
I don't know. I ain't never been locked up for 22 years. I can't say how he feel.
When does he get out?
Like 2036.
Yeah, shouts out to him. You should give me his info, that way I can email
him back
and forth. Yeah, I can too. I was going through your Instagram. I also seen you in some footage with Uzi. So that's your boy. Y'all got some new music together or something coming out?
Nah, you know, Uzi just ran down and let me know that, like, he was like, yo, bitch. He was like, yo, you hard. So I'm like, what? He was like, yeah, you hard. I'm like, damn, this the real Uzi. He was like, yo, bitch, this me. I'm from Philly. He's like, don't let this rock star shit fool you. I'm from the trenches. All that shit you rapping, you talking that shit. So I'm like, yeah. He was like, get my number. I'm like, where your phone at? I'm like, oh shit, where my phone at? So I'm like, man, don't give me your number and don't answer when I hit you up. He was like, nah, you ain't got to worry about that. I came to you. So I was like, damn, you right, bitch. It's crazy, but like it just showed like you ain't always gotta like try and do a song with somebody because they feel like I feel like you just trying to use me to get a song. It's more to it than getting a song. You feel me? I can show you how to write a book and make 10 M, but you want a song, you might not make a dime off of. You got to get what it like come to you. You feel me? That's why I don't really rush. I just build a relationship, make it work.
Slow motion is better than no motion. And Rome wasn't built in a day.
Right.
So you also got your own record label. You got anybody signed yet?
Nah, everybody who y'all see tied up with me, they really got their own record label. You feel me? Yeah, he ain't never gonna be signed to me. You gonna be free.
I like that. Yeah. So no paperwork?
I always be free. It's always paperwork, but you gonna be able to do like you. You ain't signed to me.
You should sign me.
What you do?
I'm just me.
Just you?
Yes.
You know how to make money?
Of course. I know how to make money.
A lot of money or a little bit of money? You think you can go to Quincy and make some money?
Doing what is the question?
I'm asking. Yeah. That's up to you.
It depends. I can go to Quincy and make some money. I made some money when I was in a juke joint that day.
I salute you. You make money in the world.
So, do you ever go back to Quincy?
I live in Quincy.
So, you still stay up there?
Yeah, because I feel like I get love in Quincy. Like, I could walk around out there and, like, nothing. Like, you feel me? If I go somewhere else and I'm in the barbershop and he think I'm too icy, you don't want to do something to me. I go to the barbershop in Quincy. I done paid Joe Mama light bill. Mm-hmm. I just gave you $200. I done the murder bill for you. You still owe me for a $9. I ain't sweating that. I gave you my trap phone. You been cutting my hair since I was a baby. Who finna mess with me?
That's like that El Chapo stuff, but without the drugs.
Don't put me with Chapo.
No, not like that. But you know how you know they was protecting him. He was living amongst the commoners forever.
That's what you gotta do. That's why Rollo lived on the blood. Like some people understand, some people don't. You feel me? I ain't trying to go in nobody's territory. Like to my did 150, and he ain't spent for the dub. Thought he was doing it. They don't like that.
Right.
Feel me? Ain't nobody got no role like that on your block. Like, feel me? They ain't gonna like that. Stay well. Feel me? I'm protected. Because you're not coming, Quincy.
So can I come and visit, though?
You gotta tap in with somebody.
Okay.
You gotta tap in with more than me.
Are Are you like trick in Detroit? Like it's a no fly zone. Like they gotta come tap in with you before they do anything.
It ain't about me. It's the people to me. I ain't even gonna do it to you. I tap in with me. We tapping them folks on them drugs. Control their mind. We gonna do it to you.
Now they do have a mental institution up there. It employs a lot of people in Quincy, right?
Shit, it don't work. Them people be from somewhere else.
Oh man, yeah.
Like you got a couple people got together who work, but like the realm what I'm in, like yeah, nah. Mm-mm.
So would you say that you had no choice to do what you had to do to take care of your family, living in an environment like
I had to take care of myself. Yeah. What else you gonna do?
When did you first go to jail? At what age?
When I was 15. I was driving late night. Dude had some tweeters, like a little bass room. He had little tweeters. Police done pulled me out of jail. And took me to jail, had no license.
Damn, how long was you in there? Were you scared?
Yeah, no, I had the money to go on out. You know, I just going up, going out. My mom ain't even know. What I'm talking about in the song.
Now, speaking of the music, let's get to the music. Everything that you rap about is true, is all facts. And that's apparent from this interview and right. From things that I've heard about you. Now, we want to play a couple of songs. We want to play a song that you got out right now with Mozzie. The video dropped, what, yesterday?
Yes.
So did
you want to do that? Friday.
Friday, Own Eyes.
traffic. So Fly put me in this little room, like where I like to be, like, cause it's really just Big Fly and the engineer, like, that's all we need. He come through the email, and like, yeah. Long story short, he popped back up, boom. So she like, yeah, man, I told y'all I want to rock with you. So we go listen to some beats. So we go to chop it up. She freestyling on the beat. She say something like, on I. So she like, bitch, how you want to do it? So you know, I'm like, you got to stay on that own eye float. So she come back, see it with my own eye. I'm like, stabbing the ass in the phone line. What you mean? I had to stab it. So she put that sauce on that bitch. So I like, man, you need to call Miser, man. You know Miser fuck with you. I'm like, damn, you think Miser answer for you? He like, yo, Miser real. Call Miser. Miser like, oh, you at Paramount? That's right over here. I'm finna pull up. Man, Miser, in the big. Know how to get in the gate. Ain't no come get me. None of that. Yeah, he know how to get to the gate and say something. Bitch, they gonna open it a bit faster than anybody. They might come open it with their hand. And he don't look. Got about 4 or 5 phones, the racks, and Louis Vuitton tax. He wrote one bar. House smelling like nicotine. I remember that clearly. Put that shit down, went in the booth. 8 minutes later, we here right now talking about that bitch.
I like that. When does, real quick before we play the song, when does Stabba through the phone line mean?
No, Stabba nigga in the phone line. Like in what the chain gang, it's 2 phones. They call it the blue because it's painted blue.
Uh-huh.
It's 100 people in it, bitch. 2 phones. Everybody want to talk to their people. His old lady ain't answer, so he think he can double bite. You can't double bite. She ain't answer, you gotta go. He mad at her, he mad at you. I got the woo. You playing, my mama see. Your girl ain't answer. Stab your ass. Mom, you good? Yeah, I'm gonna go to the bar. I'm be out there be about 180, they probably gonna shoot me. Anybody call, just answer, I'm be sending kite. Yeah, that nigga bleeding right here. Fake. Hey, this is what Bobby Fish Scale featuring Incubator, Spill My Ink, and Miser. On my eyes. Sometimes you gotta see that shit. It's on my eyes. Yes.
I had to see you with my own eyes.
Bitch,
I had a little
Trying to steal my side, feel I just go plain blackface. Nah, I can't even go print on what we feel. Put shark on the head, so just for the issue. Let me see.
I
been
like
trying to steal style.
Hey, can we please?
Steady by your style.
Can we hear the last re-up? I like that one. And I got a question for you about that song.
No more.
My fucking trap code. I just trapped my throat. I got rich off my throat. And you still out there broke. You wouldn't even know.
So you dropped that during Corona? Made that during COVID?
Man, that was like the first they told me that I got on the night. They spit to me to make a hook. That's why I say, make a hook, do this shit my own way. Shout out to them both.
You know, you're probably one of the first rappers that I've seen in a while that takes COVID seriously. Like, you got on the mask, you masked up and everything.
Hey, I went to think about the microphone. I have the mic thing. Hell nah.
Now, you got bigger ranking on that track right there. Did you ever go to one of the Ghetto Diamond Awards in Jacksonville? You never? Yeah. Probably the one I went to.
I was supposed to go 1 year.
But now you out.
Yeah,
now
I'm out.
And you ain't going back.
Yeah, nah, I'm not too much. I ain't traveling for nothing. I'm not rap.
So what's next for you? Like, is rapping
on? Movies, books, more property, more this, more that, just more, you know, income.
So do you flip land?
I collect. I don't really flip. We collecting right now.
Do you do the Bitcoin stuff? You got some money invested in that?
Nah, I can't really control that. I can't see that. I like to see stuff.
Now, what were
you? Like, on Kabuki. Big on. 1 minute be there, 1 minute be gone.
So land is pretty much the only thing you invest in, besides the music?
I invest in everything. Everything that investment. Like, you just gotta buy something that you get some money back if you gotta sell it. Like, I consider all that up investment. Yeah. Like, if you buy this chain, a bitch like your music, just because you got this chain. Or there, you feel me? Mm-hmm. Whatever you need to do, everybody come see you buy a chain. So, it be made you some money. It was
right.
An investment.
No, fact.
You buy a car, you fix up a donut. Like, nah, but I'm, the boy don't rap. The boy famous. I'm don't master. Man, famous all on TV, everything. Country seat on.
Well,
boy, I probably dropped out of middle school.
Well, I own my Kia out there, so that's like, you know, like, oh, thank
Salute
you. Thank you. I appreciate that.
You got that title put up?
I do. I was embarrassed to pull it in because I saw the expensive cars in here.
Yeah,
so.
But I'm in my Honda. Yeah, 2014, 15, BC.
Because cars hold no value. So, except for the...
I ain't in that because they don't hold no value. I don't know
right.
That
yes.
I knew I was coming somewhere. I ain't know where I was at.
Right.
So, I'm going to come in that slider. Yeah. I don't know what's going on. And I come... That girl made me nervous. Nah, I was nervous. I was just looking. Started looking too Quincy-ish. Robbinsville-ish. St. John-ish.
Well, you know what? JPP was right. You really are a cool dude. And I appreciate you sitting down with us today on the Talk of the Day podcast.
Yeah, check my trap.
Huh? I had to check your trap.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, because I want to, you know, make sure you're a good person and nice before I come out here. I drove an hour out here.
Ooh, I drove 4.5.
I know, but you about to make a lot of money, though. I feel that. It's not about the money with me either. Trust me, I wouldn't be on radio.
We all know I have money for a ride, right?
Oh, yeah, no, for sure.
Nah, if you want to make shit. I don't really do these lies. Don't do them. Nah, bro. I didn't get a ride one.
Oh, trust me, I did the background check.
Yeah, I'll be trying to hold on to you.
Feel that. It's not a race, it's a marathon, right?
It's not a race, it's a marathon. Greatness is a process.
Make sure you check out Bobby Fishscale tonight. He will be at Hush Lounge. I think I'm going to go. You're going to set me up with like a stack of ones that I can throw in through.
They going to set you up with a stack of ones. Shout out to the club.
All right. Hush tonight with Bobby Fishscale. Thank you so much. I hope you have a good time with me.
Oh, no. Shout out to Nah, I ain't in that because they don't hold no value. I don't know that
right. guess.
I knew I was coming somewhere. I didn't know where I was at.
Right.
So I'm going to come in that slide. What's going on? And I come. Yeah. Third row made me nervous. Nah, I was nervous. I was just looking. I started looking too Quincy's. Robert's Willie's. Like Johnny's.
Well, you know what? JPP was right. You really are a cool dude. And I appreciate you sitting down with us today on the Talk of the Day podcast. Yeah,
check my trap.
Huh? I had to check your trap.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, because I want to, you know, make sure you're a good person and nice before I come out here. I drove an hour out here.
Ooh, I drove 4.5.
I mean, but you about to make a lot of money, though.
You never about to money.
I feel that. It's not about the money with me either. Trust me, I wouldn't be here.
Y'all know I have money for real.
Oh, yeah, no, for sure.
I just be on this shit. I don't really do these live interviews and all that. I just be on this shit. I ain't really about the money.
Oh, trust me, I did the whole background check.
Yeah, I be trying to be for longevity. Yeah.
I feel that. It's not a race, it's a marathon, right?
It's not a race, it's a marathon. Greatness is a process.
Make sure you check out Bobby Fish Scale tonight. He will be at Hush Lounge. I think I'm gonna go. You gonna set me up with like a stack of ones that I can throw in through.
They gonna set you up with a stack of ones. Shout out to the club.
All right. Hush tonight with Bobby Fish Scale. Thank you so much. I'll be at this time.